It's the second round of 16 match of the AFC Asian Cup Qatar 2023 as debutants Tajikistan take on the 1996 runners-up, the United Arab Emirates, in what should be a fascinating matchup over the next 90 minutes. Well, we're at the fantastic Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium, one of the stadiums that was used for the World Cup, one of nine venues being used for this tournament, and one of four in Al Rayyan. This is the fifth of seven games that the stadium will host. It holds just over 45,000 spectators. And it is just approaching 7 o'clock in the evening local time. It's a very cool 90 degrees, not too much humidity around. It is very cool this time of year in Qatar. It is their winter time, of course, nothing like the temperatures they get in the summertime of around 50 degrees, which is almost unbearable. But we're playing football in air-conditioned stadiums on wonderful pitches, and we've seen some fantastic games that have gone before. This is match number 38 of 51. Des Corkill is alongside me. Tajikistan, very much the unknown quantity, and when we say this is fascinating, that probably is a good word to describe tonight's game.
And Tajikistan have nothing to lose. They were 10 minutes from elimination. Their coach, Peter Seghert, had set low expectations coming into this tournament because they were injury hit. Their star striker was missing, their best central midfielder missing. They've got a suspension for today. Their FIFA ratings or FIFA rankings are so much lower, the United Arab Emirates. And there's been no rotation. This is the fourth match in 16 days for 10 of the 11 starters. But they have nothing to lose, and that is a danger for a United Arab Emirates side who they've got injuries themselves, and it's big players. It's Ali Makbut and Sultan Adil, their two main strikers, are absentees today. So where are the goals going to come from? And also, you look at the form of UAE in this tournament. They flattered against Hong Kong, needing VAR interventions to help them with two penalties, held by Palestine, and then absolutely hammered by Iran. It was only 2-1, but it was a 2-1 that could easily have been 4-0. And they were very, very close to being only the third best team, close to elimination at one stage, were UAE. And there's questions, are they really behind their relatively new coach, Paolo Bento? So while the FIFA rankings suggest this is all about UAE, Kyrgyzstan, with nothing to lose, Mark, have got everything to play for.
Well, Tajikistan are about to make new ground in their football history. They waited 27 years to qualify for an AFC Asian Cup, and now they find themselves looking for a place in the quarterfinals. The UAE fell just short 5 years ago, going out in the semi-finals to the eventual winners, Qatar. But having just held on to the place in the group, they know they will have to be at their best to see off this spirited Petr Sagat side. Has to be settled tonight, possibly extra time and penalties if there's nothing to split these two sides. I'm sure both will want a positive result inside the 90 minutes. Here are the two national anthems, the Tajikistan anthem, followed by that of the United Arab Emirates.
أصحاب السمو والسعادة السيدات والسادة يرجى التكرم بالوقوف في حال القدرة لعزف النشيد الوطني لطاجكستان.
Thank you. Please remain standing for the national anthem of United Arab Emirates.
والآن يرجى الاستمرار بالوقوف في حال القدرة لعزف النشيد الوطني للإمارات العربية المتحدة.
Well, I wonder which of those anthems we've heard for the final time here in Qatar. Both sides have had differing fortunes so far. Tajikistan have played with a freedom, with an enthusiasm. They came so close to beating China in their opening game. Well, the UAE, in the absence of their two main goal scorers in the last match, certainly struggled. And it was only that late goal from Yahia that saw them hang on to second spot. Well, Petr Sagat is the coach of Tajikistan. He makes just one change to his starting 11. Yatimov is in goal. He's played every match. The back four are also ever-present with the impressive Zurabayev and Hananov at the centre of that defence. They have been excellent in every game so far. Kamalov is still suspended, so Mabachyov keeps his place wide on the right. Umabayev scored their first ever goals in the finals in the last match. The second change that Petr Sagat has made comes up front with Shamron Samiyev, who came off the bench in all three group games, getting a first start alongside Alisha Jalilov as they go in a 4-4-2 formation. A couple of players are sitting on yellow cards. Well, today's referee is Yusuke Arakai from Japan. We will welcome the two captains and will conduct the coin toss with a special AFC Asian Cup Qatar 2023 coin in an AFC partner branded box. Khalid is the captain for the UAE. Well, Nazarov, the left back, wears the captain's armband for Tajikistan. Officiating has been backed up, of course, by VAR throughout this competition so far. And another Japanese official is there tonight, Junpei Aida from Japan. Let's hope there's not too much VAR intervention tonight. Tajikistan had two goals rolled out in their final group game before they finally managed to get those much-needed points. Well, the UAE have former Career Republic boss Paolo Bento at the helm. He makes four changes. Khalid Issa continues in goal. They too sticking with a back four. Khalifa Alhamadi returns from suspension. Badr Nasser is the only one of that back four that started every game so far. Yahia and Ramadan are the two holding midfielders. And there are changes in the three in front. Fabio Lima returns. Yahia missed a penalty and scored against Iran. Kayo Kanado starts up front, having been on the bench for the last match. But two key players missing, Sultan Adil and Ali Magboot, who are both unavailable. All the match officials from Japan, the main ones anyway, the fourth official from South Africa, from Saudi Arabia. And it will be Tajikistan in the white that will get us underway, breaking new ground. Can they surprise everybody? The only debutants in this version of the AFC Asian Cup and go through to the last eight. It is Tajikistan then that get us underway, kicking from left to right in the first half. Samiyev with the first kick, the man who's come into the starting lineup tonight. 9 of the 11 have started every game so far for Petr Sagat. He is still without the suspended Kamalov, who picked up a red card in the second group game. The UAE with one or two injuries and suspension worries of their own as well, but straight away, Kayo Kanado looking to break forward. We'll see who gets off to the more positive start, Des Corkill.
Yes, they've lined up a 4-4-1-1, but they've been overloaded at the back post. That's an early overload on the far side there. I'm expecting UAE to come out and Tajikistan just to try and sit back and absorb for these first 5 minutes or so. And that's exactly what's happened. And an early free kick against them. They've got to get to survive through the first 10 minutes, I believe, Tajikistan. Then their nerves can be calmed and they can play in this round of 16 contest.
Shook her off with a foul there, just bringing down Ramadan. One of the two holding midfielders, has started every game. Abdallah Ramadan from Al Jazeera. Set pieces could be dangerous. Yatimov has been excellent. He's a very good commanding goalkeeper. Good shot stopper as well. He was called into action a few times against China in that opening match.
He may well be needed here as well. Al Ghassani and Fabio Lima are lining this one up.
It is just wide of the post from Fabio Lima. Brilliantly struck and a good one-handed save by Yatimov.
He's done well. It's probably going wide, but you don't want to make an error. You don't want it to sneak in. Peter Segert, enigmatic is the perfect word for him. He's tried to keep it as relaxed as humanly possible for Tajikistan.
He had to give up the game playing-wise at 27 due to a bad knee injury, but coaching has been very much his thing. That's punched away by Yatimov. Yahia had an eventful game in the last match against Iran. Missed a penalty and then scored the goal that effectively took them back above Palestine on goal difference. At one point, Palestine were finishing second on goals scored. It was that tight in the group. Below Iran, who had that 100% record, of course. Tajikistan finishing second to Qatar, who also won every game. It took them a while to get going. Paolo Bento was in the stands for the last match, having picked up a red card after the final whistle against Palestine in that bad-tempered second half when they too had a player sent off. But he's back on the bench tonight, directing things. Good success rate at the Korea Republic, but just really not settled into the UAE life just yet. This could be a big statement as to how far they've come under his coaching so far. It's going to be a free kick to Tajikistan, a foul by Ramadan.
And Tajikistan have got an out-and-out target man, Samiyev, and he comes in. He's 6'1". Suarev, the man he's replaced up front, is a lot more mobile, but Samiyev is a target man, and this might be somebody that Jalilov, who's got a lovely left foot, he could aim for. And the other one with the left foot, two very creative players. Umaboyev scored the free kick that got them all square in the last match of the groups. Umaboyev will take the responsibility.
Yeah, it's a lot wider than the one he scored from in the last match. Doesn't have the height to miss out. Nasser. Here's Safarov. Nazarov is the captain, an experienced international. Down the line for Jalilov. We're just trying to get away from his man Al Hashmi, who come across, but goes out for a goal kick.
Jalilov is key. If he can get on the ball, he's creative. He'll have a kind of a free roll. They've got him as a main striker, but he'll drop deep. Peter Segert trusts him implicitly. He's a will-o'-the-wisp kind of player. Former Russia under-18 international.
Halid just getting the ball under his feet and almost giving his fellow defenders a heart attack as Samiyev closed him down. They have looked a different proposition when Samiyev has come on in all three games. I'm slightly surprised he's making his first start tonight, but he does get the nod ahead of Rustam, who had started the three games previously. As well taken by Safarov. That last game was massively eventful for Tajikistan against Lebanon. They had two goals ruled out for offside, Mabatshoev, and then Kasim Alzin was sent off after VAR upgraded his yellow to a red. Jalilov had a goal disallowed as well. 17 shots they had in that game, eventually paying dividends, getting the two goals that put them through. Umaboyev and Kamrokulov in the 92nd minute. really did spark those wild celebrations on the touchline.
And back home in Dushanbe as well. Coach was referring to them in his pre-match comments. He said it was like the country had won, but they haven't ended their story yet. They want to take it on and create even more history. Tajikistan in the quarterfinals, that's the possibility.
Well, it shows how well they're progressing at the moment. They're officially 106 in the FIFA rankings, but in the live updated rankings that update all the time, they are 100. So at the next official ranking, they could well be inside the world's top 100 with a good showing here, which is a remarkable achievement for a nation that only played its first international back in 1992, since the breakup of the former Soviet Union. Good solid challenge coming in on Kaya Kanado.
Kananov, very quick. Jurbayev provides the steal and the experience. Kananov is the big centre-half, if there is one.
Yahia, no way through. Azabi into the penalty area, looking for a second opportunity. Samiyev, there's a high boot there from Ramadan, which has just caught Samiyev.
It is a free kick, it is both high. Interesting, though, for the second time, United Arab Emirates have had an overload over on the right-hand side. So they're just trying to capitalise on a very narrow defensive setup from Tajikistan.
Referee just having a word with Tanun Alzabi about something. Yes, Samiyev has got 7 international goals to his name. They do have goals running through this Tajikistan side. A late challenge overstretched there from Ehsan, which will give the UAE a free kick.
Exaggeration from Sultan Zayed. Scored in the first game, an important goal against Hong Kong. UAE have spluttered throughout this tournament. Semi-finalists in the last two editions, isn't it? And they haven't shown that form here. Not yet, anyway.
Very close to winning this competition in 1996, the UAE. They drew 0-0 with Saudi Arabia before losing on penalties in the final. That's nicely pulled back. Kaio Kanado was just leaning back, though, when he hit the shot. He thought he took a deflection, but only a goal kick given.
Well, Kanado, they're playing without an out-and-out number nine. He comes in late onto this ball. I think he's claiming it's flicked off a hand there. And I tell you what, I think there's a VAR check going on here.
The referee just holding things up for the moment. There's been a lot of VAR interventions in this so far. Australia became the first team to put their place in the quarterfinals. Whatever check there was is now over. We're back underway again. They beat Indonesia by 4-0 a little bit earlier on. That set them up to play either Saudi Arabia or the Korean Republic in the last 8. Winners here will play either Iraq or Jordan back in this stadium on the 2nd of February. Nasser. Alzabi by Yahia. Again, they're claiming a handball that's gone all the way back to Yatimov in goal.
Some big challenges coming in already in the midfield area from Tajikistan.
Talked about the free-flowing football that we've seen here with today's game. 91 goals in 37 games, and we should well pass the attendance record today. 937,000 in China back in 2004. Previous, before today's games, 925,000. There's well over 12,000 in here, plus what was in the stadium for the earlier game today. He's gone for a goal kick.
Samiyev, though, he bullied his centre-back. That was interesting. Samiyev offers something very different. Khalifa Alhamadi tried to barge him out of the way. Samiyev wasn't having any of it.
Sultan. Good play again. Alzabi just finding a little bit of space. Nasser. This is where they excel when they're running with the ball. Good ball in. Ramadan just too much on it for Caio Canedo, Fabio Lima won't keep it in play. Another goal kick to Tajikistan this time.
Again, they're trying to play that to the back post. That time there wasn't an overload. Good defensive work on the left-hand side by Isong.
4 teams have made it through to the knockout round for the first time in their history. Syria, Tajikistan, Palestine and Indonesia, who have now got out, of course. But good to see some of the lower-ranked nations, if you like, coming through.
Nice bright start by UAE. Physical start by Tajikistan.
Here the touch was heavy, allowed Safarov to win the ball back. It was an outstretched leg from Yahia that's given away. In fact, it's an offside on the far side. She'll give a free kick to Tajikistan. We do have the semi-automated offside, of course, for the big decisions. We'll just see, just marginally off.
Also got the spider cam here today as well, which is an expensive toy for the directors to play with.
It does give some brilliant shots, though, of the way that the play is shaping up. That's clumsy. Ramadan picks off the loose ball. Just got there before Hananov and felt he was fouled. Hananov has stayed down. Referee saw nothing untoward in the challenge. Down the line by Safarov. Chase on here for Samiev. Al-Hamadou should get there first. Back from suspension today after that red card against Palestine. Jalilov. Essen. Umabayev. Looking to try and string a few passes together to Tajikistan. They haven't held on to the ball much so far. They're conceding a lot in possession, but they'll try and press now. It's Jalilov. Just flicked away from him by Yahia. Was a trip on Ramadan, and that may have injured himself in the process as well here.
That's an awkward fall there from Ramadan. Not happy the UAE players, because he does look to be in a fair amount of pain.
Well, that knee just seemed to straighten a little as he fell and just jarred possibly. That's looks fairly inconspicuous, but often cruciate injury or tendon injuries can occur. A very straight leg when he went down.
Yeah, that does not look good, and he stayed down. Very often you can tell when it's a serious injury. It's no more than a flick. The foul is no more than a flick, but the consequence could be really bad, you feel, for Abdallah Ramadan. And he's very important to UAE and Paulo Bento in the heart of midfield. And the message coming back, I think, from the physios isn't a positive prognosis.
No, they are having to make the change here, UAE. So Abdallah Ramadan's game comes to a premature end here in the first half. Over 100 league games for Al Jazeera, very experienced in that holding midfield role. But straight away, the way he went down, his initial reaction was that there was a big problem with that knee.
The reaction from the player, yeah, it's so often you can tell, yeah, the stretcher's being called. Well, I really feel for Abdallah Ramadan here. And with the other injuries that they've got up front, there's work for Paulo Bento to do to manipulate his squad to try to get a result. But firstly, the good news is Ramadan is up, and it looks like he might be able to hobble off, holding his hamstring.
They are going to make the change, though. Abdullah Al-Menhali from Al-Wada is going to come on. Has come on in 2 of the 3 group games so far. Not a regular starter for Al-Wada, just the 1 this season, but getting a chance here in a big international tournament to stake his claim. Let's hope Ramadan's injury is not too serious, especially if the UAE go through, of course, only a few days before they play their, or they would play their quarter-final match.
He's holding his hamstring. Yes. Just, he was in full flow. His standing foot was nicked.
confirmation then of the first substitution. Mohamed Halley. Now there will be a slow regroup. There's Al Hashmi. To Khalid in goal. Al-Hamadi. Seven of the nations through to the round of 16 have lifted this trophy previously. Defending champions Qatar are there, of course, as are the four-time winners Japan. And you have to feel for players who go off early in games such as this and with such importance attached to them. And that could be the end of his tournament, should they go through.
Yeah, he went straight down the dressing room. That looked fairly serious.
Al-Hamadi. Al-Zabi, just out of the reach of Yahia. Kamenov goes back to his goalkeeper, Yatimov. First time clearance. Samiev just jumped a little bit early there. There's a first touch for the substitute, Alman Halley. Looks like he's gone over to the right of that midfield two. Go to Saget again. Pacing that technical area as he does. It's interesting to watch because there's the lead coming out. Bachuev with a shot which has just gone wide. Almost got there before Khalid, who came racing out of his area.
It's a lovely ball in by Samiev. Bachuev does get there first, but just can't direct it on target. When your goalkeeper comes out, he's got to make it. He's got to be more positive than Khalid was then. It's a nervy start by the experienced goalkeeper. He's nearly caught on his line and he's a little slow off his line there.
He's been an international for over 13 years. Khalid. Alman Halley. Khalid. Fabio Lima being tightly marked there by Nazarov. Jalilov to have been nudged in the back, and the referee agrees on this occasion. Free kick to Tajikistan.
It doesn't take a lot for Jalilov to go down, but that was a proper little thump there. Two hands and a bit of a knee for added value.
Did play at youth level for Russia, Alisher Jalilov, up to under 21 before switching to Tajikistan for his full international debut. Hananov. Surabayev. Knocked on by Jalilov. Samiev is trying to turn away from his man. Umabayev puts his shirts back behind the ball for the UAE, but the pressure's still coming here from Tajikistan. Nazarov. Sultan should get that one in the corner. Another throw in though to Tajikistan.
If Umabayev or Jalilov can get a free hit from the edge of the penalty area, they are both very dangerous.
Did lose narrowly to Qatar in their second group game to Tajikistan. Just a single goal after Kamalov was sent off. Another red card that was upgraded by VAR.
And they've got a two-match ban for it as well.
Yeah, serving the second of those two matches today. One-way shot is just charged down there by Yahia. Offside flag's gone up.
Otherwise.
Hartsy Mahz again there as Jalilov went into the penalty area and went over.
Jalilov hanging on the shoulder and hanging a long, 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 long way offside.
Hashmi it was with the challenge. more possession than the opposition in two of their three group games. They were particularly good at the start of the game against China. Tajikistan could have had three in the first half, but the Chinese defended well. Ali Zabar. Now Yahia. Nasser. He's got room to cross. Closed down quickly by Mabachuev.
Asking a different role of Nasser today. Asking him to get forward a lot more. He was playing as one of three centre-backs in the last match. Versatility at the top level, so important.
Hananov's header. Very commanding. He and Zurabayev have been very difficult to beat in the air. Alhamadi. Essen.
What a brilliant challenge that was by Zurabayev. Had to time that perfectly.
Already approaching the midway point of the first half, still 0-0 in that round of 16. Tajikistan against United Arab Emirates. As Bahia, because they were the hosts in 2019. Bahia's ball out wide. Sultan Al-Menhali, the substitute. In good shape, Tajikistan, making sure there's no space for those UAE forward players to try and exploit. This is Alhamadi.
That diagonal is the way UAE are trying to break the 4-4-2 lock. Six times now they've tried. Three to each side.
Al-Menhali. Sultan. To be patient tonight, UAE. Just now, Fabio Lima coming very deep and switching over to this near side in a bid to try and add a little bit more creativity into that midfield. Threaded through for Kayo Canedo. By Jalilov.
He did well. Oh, Hashmi's a big, strong centre back.
Appearance in the Asian Cup finals for UAE. So that's grown in stature really over the years. So goes right across the face of goal. I'm not too sure who that was intended for. It's comfortable for Nasser to tidy up in the corner.
I think it was an attempt on goal by Nazarov. Not his moment of glory, but interesting the way he was able to drive forward. He really went with the experienced fullback.
Hashmi. I mentioned they were runners-up, or whether it's the semi-finals in 2019, UAE beaten by the eventual winners Qatar, a heavy 4-0 defeat. They were third place in 2015 in Australia, beat Iraq in that playoff. Another good-looking ball in, headed away by Safarov. Had to be sure with that one because Yahia was right behind him.
Good defending from Safarov, attacking the ball, didn't wait for it. That's rather aimless. Oh, Khalid.
Lovely touch from Khalid, but he managed to recover before Samiyev could get there. Finds Nasser. A couple of times now he's had to come out of his area and show good footwork. Goalkeepers don't just have to be a goalkeeper these days, have to almost play as a sweeper at times as well.
I don't think he's used his hands yet.
Yahia. Ha! Hananov falling over and into the ball, but managed to keep his arm out of the way. Umabayev has had to come very deep for that one. It will be a free kick. Foul by Sultan.
Isan did well there, taking it on the half turn. There's Hananov. It ain't in a textbook. No not one I've read anyway. If you're playing in the Iranian top flight, the Iranian Pro League, Persian Pro League, you're a good player. And Hanov, I think, is showing that already. Still young.
Still only 23 years of age, Vedat Hananov. He's been at Persepolis a couple of years now. Nasser with a throw. Good defending again. And Tajikistan just keeping it tight at the back. Mabachev. Samiev's with him, but good tackling back by Yahira. May just have clipped the ankle there of Mabachev. Play continues. Yahia. Get to the byline here. Good footwork, just lost it slightly. Manages to recover. Still, he keeps the ball in play and eventually goes for a goal kick. Fist pump from Safarov, who managed to stay away from getting the final touch.
Mabachev, he's still down. Doesn't seem to be a lot there. And then, so good with his dribbling, he beat himself. He's lively though, Yaya. The switch to him has been a key ingredient of UAE's attacking policy in this opening 27 minutes.
He does take turns with his coaching staff, Petr Sagar, depending on whether they're attack or defence. His side have managed to go almost the opening half an hour so far without conceding a goal. And sure, they're breaking the game into sections to try and see their way through. That's the philosophy that's worked for them so far. Samiyev just beaten to the ball by Alhamadi. That's another play. Sultan won't keep it in over on that far side.
He's made a difference, Samiyev. The extra physicality. He's just beaten to the ball there. That's better from Alhamadi, but he's keeping both centre-backs very alert to the ball being played into him. In terms of chances, Mark, the best one going to Matsu Berek.
Just off target as he got to the ball before Khalid is Umabayev. UAE will be mindful of any free kicks given away around the edge of the penalty area, having seen the way that he put his side in front with their first AFC Asian Cup goal in that last match against Lebanon. Chukarov. By Essen. Jalilov and Essen trying to work hard on that far side. Now they might have a bit of an angle for a ball in. Umabayev trying to play it back in towards Jalilov. Good challenge by Sultan to get the ball away. He felt he'd been hauled back there by Jalilov, but nothing given. Throwing's been taken, and that will be a corner to Tajikistan.
Really important challenge there from Sultan Zaid, because there were two Tajik players trying to come onto that, one of whom was Jalilov, the other one Isam. And if he didn't get that challenge in, there was a real opening for Tajikistan.
Tajikistan fans trying to will this ball towards goal. It'll be swung in by Essen. In low, wasn't a great delivery. Nazarov just hoisted that one high. Umabayev with a header. Zurabayev, nice little chip into the box. Hananov! Brilliant leap! He just hung in the air and guided the ball into the back of the net. And Vedat Hananov picks an opportune moment to get a third international goal. And it's a goal that puts Tajikistan in front. Just used the pace on the ball to help it on its way. Khalid got a touch but couldn't keep it out. Tajikistan lead by a goal to nil.
The work from his centre-back partner, Zhurabayev. When he got it with his back to goal, I didn't think there was any way that Zhurabayev was going to be able to produce something. But he's just hung the ball up to the edge of the six-yard box. And Hananov, who is holding up a shirt of one of his teammates. Look at this, though. This is a centre-back acting like a winger. And then any centre-forward would be happy with that. Khalid has smashed his head against the post in trying to make a save. Wonderful cross.
glorious little flicked header. And I hope Halid is all right, because he's got himself right on the back of the neck there.
Well, he got a hand to it, but such was the placement of that ball from Hanunov, who I don't think saw it go in because he was falling backwards, may just have caught it at the last minute. Delight for Peter Sagat and his coaching staff. And Hanunov, we said he'd been brilliant defensively, now he's added in attacking sense as well. And look what it means to those Tajikistan fans. They've had some tough luck with VAR decisions up to this point, but that was as good a goal as they have scored. And it came courtesy of two central defenders from the set piece. Halid still receiving some treatment. Of course, they don't take any chances these days if it is a serious head injury.
It was a brave attempt to go and get the ball by Halid. Just beyond him. And you do wonder whether or not there's going to be a concussion call. They've got an experienced player on the bench. But it's the work here of Zhurabayev. You do not expect your big, rugged centre-back to show skills like that. What a header. Beautifully done. Up against two good centre-backs.
I think Halid will be okay. Well, a couple of other goalkeepers in the squad, of course, both available off the bench. Still seems to be a little bit of concern around about him at the moment, but well, he did his level best to get across to that one. Got a hand to it, Halid, but couldn't keep it out. He'll be okay to continue, and now UAE have to rally and come from behind.
Could almost hear the cheer in Dushanbe.
I'm not too sure what's happening at the moment. The referee's in discussion with the fourth official.
They're still concerned about the goalkeeper, I think. Fourth official is saying to Paolo Bento, it's a smack on the back of the head and it's a quite a nasty one.
Yeah, it looks like the officials may force the change here if they're concerned. Referee is Yusuke Arakai from Japan. He's a very experienced referee. He was in charge for Australia, Uzbekistan earlier in the competition. Also in charge for Tajikistan's 6-1 win over Pakistan back in November as well in a World Cup qualifier. Maybe it's their lucky charm.
Well, there's another check coming on here for Halid. And you might be right. It could well be that the referee is saying, listen, I've got the health of the players as my first focus.
Well, there is still some concern. Halid has obviously said to the physio that he's okay, but still the referee is talking to the physio. Happy now, Mr. Arakai. So we will be okay to continue. We will get through to half time, I presume, and have another look at Halid. It will be UAE to get us back underway with the restart. It's that a 5-6 minute stoppage. But Tajikistan lead by a goal to nil. Hanunov with the goal.
That was really good from a referee. You've not seen that kind of concern before. All part of the well-being of the players is paramount in his responsibilities.
Yeah, it is good. Head injuries in particular have been very much in the spotlight over the last few seasons, and there is a protocol in place now that if you do go off with concussion, then there is a certain amount of time you have to stay away from the game, which all for the players' well-being, of course. But good to see the referee showing concern with his officials there, but everything seems okay now. This is Samiev for Tajikistan.
He's got the throw in. He's difficult. He's awkward. He's putting his body in the way.
It's a big, powerful player, Samiev. Played mainly in Belarus and Moldova before a spell at Rubin Kazan. putting his chance from the start here. Took a deflection. Samiyev almost helped that one across. If he'd got a touch on that, that could have caused Halid some problems. And it's been turned behind by Sultan for a corner.
Jalilov is saying to Isan, why weren't you attacking that back post? Because it's a tapping if he does. Well, they're in the ascendancy, Tajikistan. If they could nick a second.
This is where they scored the goal from, a corner this side. And short this time to Jalilov. Whipped in again towards that near post, straight into the midriff of Halid, who looks alert now as he tries to get his side moving forward. Things for Paolo Bento and his coaching staff to get their heads around now.
It's worth Tajikistan testing whether Halid has actually got everything all right about him. Surprised they didn't put a cross under the crossbar for him there. If he takes it, all well and good, but if he doesn't, he could well be rattled. Particularly with Samiyev in front of him.
He's 34 years of age, Halid. He's not the oldest in the squad. That goes to one of the other goalkeepers, Ali Kassif, who's 36. Sultan Adil was the real star of their first two games. The 19-year-old scored in both games, but picked up a knock and unavailable. That could be where the UAE falls short in goals, but here they come on the attack now. Brilliant side foot coming in with Sultan. Nobody picked up the run, but he's hit it straight at Yatimov with no real pace, and that should have been the equaliser.
That's that overload again. It's the third time it's come through. Zaid Sultan does really well to attack the ball. He scored like this against Hong Kong. Does well, puts it on target, straight to the goalkeeper. But Tajikistan have got to be careful of that overload.
Mabatshoev, Samiyev, Jalilov on a forward run once again. Good pace from Jalilov, but the angle was always tight. Closed down by Al Hashmi and can only hit it into those supporters behind the goal.
It's a rip-roaring game now. Hugely difficult for Jalilov. But he's got so much confidence in his ability, and he's had a go.
Nazarov, just missed by Samiyev. Interesting if he'd have just knocked that one into his path. Well, Peter Saget, who took over in Tajikistan in January 2022. They won the King's Cup in Thailand that year. 2023 Merdeka Cup in Malaysia with a very young squad, just over 21 years of age when they won that title. Only the fourth non-Tajikistan coach that has been at the helm, but a man who is already endearing himself to them, their supporters, as he did when he was in Indonesia with PSM Makassar. Big cult hero there.
He's a great character. But as you can see on the line, well, he's not on the technical area at the moment. Very, very passionate when he is down there.
Poor ball in behind Sultan gives Tajikistan a throw. Zurabayev, Nazarov. Giving away to Yahia. That is Zabai. Nasser. And off, back on defensive duty with a relatively comfortable header.
He didn't know where that had gone. He was worried that had gone behind him.
There's Jalilov again, just pressuring Al Hashmi. With a really pressing Samiyev in particular, working along that back line, putting all those defenders under pressure.
Team have a game plan, Mark, and they're playing to it, but there is Sultan once again.
And good defending again from Zurabayev. Jalilov really was a standout in that first game against China, not afraid to shoot from distance. They had plenty of shots in that game. Only two shots on target, though, but 12 of their 20 came from outside the box. They were looking to shoot at every opportunity and test the Chinese defence. Yatimov quickly off his line, reads the game very well. the goalkeeper. We've seen that on a number of occasions. Rustam Yatimov.
Good goalkeeper, good height. Makes the shots you expect him to, makes the saves you expect him to make from shots. Also, as you say, reads the game well. Dominates the penalty area. What a game we've got now, Mark.
Yeah, this is the first day of four doubleheaders for the round of 16. Iraq against Jordan and Qatar, the host nation, against Palestine tomorrow from Al Bayt. Promises to be a fantastic occasion. Some big strong sides left as well. Saudi Arabia, Korea going up against each other. Bahrain, Japan. Islamic Republic of Iran against Syria. Oh, there's a feast of football here, and it has been for the last couple of weeks now here in Doha, Qatar. Here's Yahia. Good angle ball in again. You could see the tension. The intention there was to try and pick out Fabio Lima, but just too much on the ball in.
Great idea by Yahia. First time he's really had a little bit of space. Fabio Lima's made a good early run. On that left-hand side, Nazarov and Isam have really, really got to be so alert of the runs in behind them.
Well, it's been a handful, Samiyev. It's only the third time these sides have ever met. They did meet in a friendly in March last year, which ended 0-0. Petr Sagut was quick to say both sides are vastly different from the 11s that played that day. Their only other meeting came back in 2020 when the UAE went 3-2 in a friendly in Dubai.
I think they came from 2-1 down late on to win that, so...
Oh, and again, had a little bit too much place on it from Abachuev.
Jalilov is really giving him a hard time, but that's a fabulous pass in.
Jalilov was in an offside position, so not attempting to go for the ball. So when you look at the teams that are in the round of 16, we mentioned previous winners of this competition. Japan have 4, Saudi Arabia and Iran 3, Korea Republic with 2. So these are the experienced teams in the AFC Asian Cup that have made it through. But every year or every edition, there's a surprise package. Could it be Tajikistan to go even further in this competition? Long way to go yet in this game, but having got themselves in front, they would have said to them that was the important thing, get in front and see what happens from there. Yahia cutting back inside again, went for goal, bounced awkwardly in front of Yatimov, but again the goalkeeper's positioning perfectly good, got his feet right behind it,
and his handling's very good as well. That bounces off him. There's two green shirts, Canedo amongst them, ready to put a little tap in. He's had an impressive opening 43 and a half, 44 minutes. As have Tajikistan, generally.
Well, probably be around 6 or 7 minutes added time for the injuries that we had in the first half to Ramadan and Khalid. Hamadi. Yahia. Got Nasser outside him. Just showed a little bit too much of that to Umabayev. Sultan forward again. Fabio Lima playing that one into Yahia on the edge of the area, who is caught right on the edge of the box by Shukarov. It was a relatively clumsy challenge. He was drawn into that one.
Oof. Sometimes you don't put your foot in, you don't need to. And a free kick in this area, Fabio Lima might fancy this.
Additional time is 7 minutes.
7 minutes, that was a pretty good guess.
Calculation, Mark, calculation.
Maybe I should become an assistant referee. Free kick then to the UAE, who trail by a goal to nil on the stroke of half-time. Yatimov with work to do.
Fabio Lima, left foot.
man lying down behind the wall. Yahir will go for the right-footed option, which is probably favouring the right-footer with the angle, but Fabio Lima might just try and test Yatimov at that near post. This is where his wall placement needs to be spot on. Jalilov, the man lying down. It is Yahir, straight into the defensive wall. Fabio Lima hoists it back forward again. Ali Zabai tries his luck from distance, but well wide. He's claiming a deflection once again. Oh, the referee has changed his mind. They were furious there in unison, really. UAE did take a deflection, though.
From the previous free kick, it was a good wall. We've seen a couple of walls disintegrate, particularly when Tajikistan got their equaliser in the last group game. That was a good wall.
Fabio Lima with the corner near post. It was Caio Canedo arriving at pace and wasn't too far away.
That's very good from him, but there's a man on the line. If that's on target, I think it's deflected away. But it's good movement. Again, there has been good movement on a couple of occasions by UAE forwards. Sultan on one occasion on the back post, Canedo there on the front post.
Canedo got his Emirati citizenship 3 years ago. He's become a regular member of the national team since then. Essen hasn't seen too much of the ball in this first half. Had a little look up there. Samiyev in the middle. Jalilov on the overlap. Had to go long there because Samiyev was at the back post. A bit too much on it from Jalilov. That's clever, though, to win the throw-in off Al-Zabai.
Love the work of Samiyev. He's worked so hard. Jalilov thought, though, he was 17 foot tall with that cross.
Safarov with the throw. Jalilov went for the flick, but only presents it to Yahir. Al-Zabai. Russell McGonagall as Safarov hammers the ball goalwards.
Yahir's having a real pop at the referee. I'm not really sure what. Maybe he's just frustrated because he had a real go when his wayward shot was deflected over.
That was good play by Alman Halley, who just got there first to stab that into the path of Canedo. Al-Zabai. Yahir trying to weave his way through again. Great block from Safarov, who just threw himself in the way of that to concede the corner.
That is wonderful defending. He's been bitten, he's gone the wrong way. He's had a can't let a shot come in or a cross. Thrown himself into the challenge. UAE are knocking on the door. You can feel a goal coming. But Tajikistan defending well.
In towards that big post, it's a strange save, just spooned up by Yatimov. First sign of a little bit of nervousness maybe from the goalkeeper we've seen. Yahir heads back across goal. Yatimov doesn't get there again. And well, Fabio Lima clatters into Safarov, and eventually the goalkeeper does gather. But he made that problem all of his own there. Instead of trying to catch the ball, he just spooned it away. Eventually gathers.
Acrobatics here from, is it Safarov? Both goalkeepers now in trouble, but that, as you say, was self-induced. A strange one. This is the, well, it's a spoon save. It's a lovely ball in, but it's into his midriff, and he's been so clever up till now, so secure. A bit of volleyball. Excellent setting.
Samiyev gets to the byline again. Over Khalid, and not for the first time, Sultan forced to concede the corner. Just down below us, Mabachuev actually clattered into Paolo Bento after he played that ball and was apologising to the UAE coach. And they've got another corner to defend.
What play by Samiyev once again.
chance and to deliver the Tajikistan corner. Can they get another before half-time? It's into the near post again. Sultan is there, but come back out to Essen to have a second go at delivery. Hanging ball in again towards Samiev. It's just helped on its way by Nasser.
Cleverly done, avoids the corner there. Helps it out for a throw-in. Ayman Youssef of Iraq has had the best centre-forward performance so far in this tournament. It's old-school, number nine stuff. Samiev is running him a close second.
Well, you're here trying to bring the ball away, well, with the throw. Deep inside his own half, final minute of added time. Yetimov's goal hasn't really been threatened since that opening goal from Hananov, just past the half hour. It's Al Hashmi. Fabio Lima. Al Zabi. Nasser. Resource from the Tajikistan supporters. Yahia. Nasser had continued his run. Went for the low cross. Hananov was there to block at the near post. Slices the clearance though. Still, it's not cleared! And just wide, there's a big claim for handball from the UAE players in the build-up to that. And that might be one for VAR to take a look at. Fabio Lima went close, though.
It's a miss kick by Hananov. Well, it has hit a hand. VAR will check. But this is one of those where his hand is absolutely next to his body. But it has hit a hand. And such has been the strictness of VAR that I fear here for Tajikistan. But it's complete, and I'm pleased about that.
Yeah, it would have been a harsh one. All about the unnatural position of the arm, of course, but when you're charging balls down from that sort of distance, it's very difficult to get the arm out of the way. It is just a corner. Fabio Lima to take it for UAE. That was an important flick away. Just in front of goal as the half-time whistle goes from the Japanese referee. Well, an eventful first half that saw Hananov get a headed goal beyond Halid to put his side in front. UAE were forced into that early change, but it is Hananov's goal that separates the teams and a deserved lead at half-time.
Yeah, Tajikistan, what a goal it was, made by the two centre-backs, superbly converted by Hananov, and they've been defensively very strong, very disciplined. UAE are knocking at the door, but goalkeeper Yatimov hasn't had serious work to do, and Tajikistan are on the cusp, well, halfway towards what would be a famous occasion.
Maybe possible changes at half-time for UAE. Paolo Bento in discussion, but the job is only half done for Tajikistan. They know there's a lot more work to do. Half-time here at the Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium in Al Rayyan. It's Tajikistan 1, United Arab Emirates 0.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, Tajikistan first out for the second half, leading by a goal to nil. You can understand their enthusiasm to get out and get going because they know there is a long, long 45 minutes plus ahead of them in this second half. Well, there is a change about to be made by the UAE. Abdullah Al-Hamadi is going to come on. So we have two Al-Hamadis on the field for the UAE. That's Al-Hashmi that's made way. So Abdullah Al-Hamadi comes on to partner Khalifa Al-Hamadi. UAE just making their way out. There was a little bit of concern maybe about the goalkeeper, Khalid, just before half-time. The medical staff went straight up to him as he came off the field, and he's still not out on the pitch as yet, but well, the UAE need a response. But you were looking down the team sheet, Des, at half-time, and there are not too many options available to Paolo Bento in an attacking sense.
Yeah, Ali Salah is probably the only one who you think can come off the bench and change things going forward. They brought on a more attack-minded left-back, so the replacement may well see the new Al-Hamadi going in as a left wing-back. But all that does is give them a little bit more width. It's how they can support Caio Canedo and Fabio Lima. Everyone's ready to kick off here, but there's no goalkeeper for UAE. I wouldn't recommend starting without a goalkeeper.
He's here, here he comes. Making his 76th appearance for the national team tonight, Khalid Issa. Played at the 2012 Olympics and the 2018 FIFA Club World Cup. Over 200 league appearances for Al Ain. Very experienced, but did receive that knock on the head when he tried to keep out Hananov's header. That is the separating factor between these two teams as we go into the second half. Potential for extra time and penalties if it is level after 90 minutes. What tactics, I wonder, will we see from Tajikistan in the second half?
Very similar, I suspect, to the first, where they did sit back, but not exclusively. They have two banks of four. But Isam and Matsubayev down the right-hand side, both trying to get forward in front of the support of the front two.
Sultan's ball into Fabio Lima, just trying to turn away from his man. Hananov's header sends it straight back to Fabio Lima. Sultan, nice footwork, back to Fabio Lima, bent him with the outside of the boot. Yatimov just clatters into his own player, but got a good punch on the ball. And now there could be a break on here for Tajikistan.
That was really good goalkeeping by Yatimov. Hananov seemed to have control, but Yatimov, we criticised him in the first half for not dealing with one cross that came in that time. Very, very commanding.
Fabio Lima, Al-Zabi.
Al Ghassani had made a great run. And there's Alhamadi. And immediately can see the wing back is trying to get forward.
Yahia. Canada goes down on the edge of the penalty area. Roars from the UAE supporters behind the goal.
Seemed like he was looking for some kind of contact. He was leaning into his man. But there is a chirping help, but it does look like Canedo is already on his way down. Feels a... Right. No, is it in the penalty area? It is, isn't it? First contact's outside.
Well, Canedo's also got hold of Zurabayev as well, so it is six of one, half a dozen of the other. And it is play on, no official check from VAR. We'll be looking at every incident, of course. First time that VAR has been used in all 51 games at the AFC Asian Cup this year, and it has been used on numerous occasions.
Yeah, Tajikistan know that very, very well.
Two goals disallowed in their final group game against Lebanon before they eventually got over the line in that one with a 2-1 win. Yahia, given away again, he was just behind Azabi. Semiev challenges Yahia. Touch off to Alzabi again, but not on the same wavelength as Caio Canedo, and the ball goes out of play for a goal kick.
You mentioned the Merdeka Cup victory for Tajikistan earlier. I was at that game, and Tajikistan sat back and took a lot of pressure. It's not the Asian Cup, it's not UAE, but they are comfortable sitting back and defending and hitting on the break. It worked in the Merdeka Cup, why not in the Asian Cup?
Beat Malaysia 2-0 in that final. Should have been a four-team tournament, but Palestine withdrew due to their issues. India were the other team that took part. There's Nasser. Yahia. What a free kick this time on Yahia Nader.
Shukarov. He's the base of the midfield for Tajikistan. Just 21, it's a lot of responsibility for a player so young. He's doing a great job. Doesn't play for a big club either.
Well, he'd only made one appearance before this Asian Cup. That was in that Merdeka Cup final against Malaysia. But he's been a starter in every game so far for Petr Sagut, such is the trust that he's put in the youngster to occupy that position in that central midfield area alongside Umabayev. Here's Nasser. Alhamadi's added a different dimension and a bit of pace down that far side. That's missed by Safarov. Hananov went over, went to ground very early there. In the corner, given away. Hananov complaining about something.
Ball there that's outside the penalty area. Or is it inside the box?
The ball's gone out of play.
Yeah, no,
it's a goal kick.
It was a goal kick. That's the correct decision, but I thought initially it had been given as a free kick for that handball we saw by Hananov. Because it was outside the penalty area, it's not a penalty instant. VAR won't have a look at it.
Yeah, Hananov straight away got back to his feet to protest that decision, and the referee changed his mind. Goal kick cleared along by Yatimov. Bounces away from Samiev. Jalilov headed out to Samiev. Ripped in. Jalilov took a deflection which sends the ball looping up into the air off Nasser, and comfortable for Khalid.
You prefer Jalilov playing the ball into Samiev. But role reversal there. Nearly came off.
Nasser. Interesting competitive start to this second half. Alhamadi. Al-Menhali, first half substitute for the injured Ramadan. It's just been run out of play though by Khalifa Alhamadi.
If we get up to the 70 minute mark, I feel the UAE might begin to get a little bit more desperate. One or two defensive holes might open up.
Doesn't look too happy at the moment, Paolo Bento. July 2023, he took over as UAE coach. Won his opening match against Costa Rica, 4-1 in a friendly. That's handball by Fabio Lima. They've had some big-name coaches as well at UAE in the past. Back in the old days, Don Revy. More recently, Carlos Queiroz, Henri Michel, Roy Hodgson, Dick Advocaat. Bert van Marwijk was actually in charge when they qualified for this tournament.
It's interesting, the man management of these big-name foreign coaches.
Babatshuayev, nice ball inside for Safarov. It was aimed in towards Jalilov, but the defender was tight to him. Still, it's not cleared.
Magnificent defending.
Safarov. Height on it, Nasser comfortably heads the ball away. Fabio Lima.
Khalifa Alhamadi saved a certain goal then. He just stretched, he was second favourite to get that ball, but he dived in, stretched out a long right leg to get there ahead of Jalilov.
Comfortable again for Zurabayev. Umabayev, Jalilov allows it to run cleverly, Samiyev, nice little reverse ball into Essen, Jalilov goes one way, Essen might try his luck, went for the curler, pushed away by Halid for a corner, went for that bottom corner there, great play, shifted his body, opened his shoulders, had a good save.
I've seen him do this for Estoril in the AFC Champions League, where he likes to get on that right foot, cuts in from the left-hand side. It's a good save, you'd expect Halley to save it. Nonetheless, on the break, Nissan has nearly made it two.
Essen is in a second spell at Istanbul. He started his career at some 8 years ago. Swinging corner here from Umabayev. Knows how to deliver the quality. Four players all in a line. Hooked in again, header from Mabachuev is just too high. Couldn't get over the ball to get the downward force on it.
Of all the players in the penalty area, Mabachuev is not the one you want there. You want Hananov or Jurabayev to get the challenge in.
Strong on the ball, Almen Harley, given away though, Jalilov is just too far ahead of him and he's furious with the weight on that pass because that was a glorious opportunity to play in. Jalilov would have been one-on-one with Halid.
He doesn't mind having a go at his teammates, does he, Jalilov, but understandable there. Shukarov, having got the chance to play the ball in, has just overhit it. Good goalkeeping, good alert goalkeeping by Halid.
Poor play by the UAE. Almen Harley giving it away. Not a happy man.
No, no. And Peter Seghert's reaction down on the bench as well was quite emotional. As long as it's channeled in the right way, that emotion can be a winning factor.
Here, Nader. Almen Harley, now Fabio Lima. They're having to be patient, UAE, because they just can't find any pockets of space with this well-organised Tajikistan midfield, and Essen played the ball forward. Here is Jalilov in a goal. Jalilov straight at the goalkeeper. Halid recovers, he gets there first. Good alert goalkeeping from the experienced Halid in goal, but Jalilov denied a one-on-one a moment or so ago. Has had one there and been denied by the goalkeeper.
Didn't quite have the pace or the confidence to take it on. So, shot from outside the penalty area. That made Halid's job a little bit more manageable.
It's a good open game of football now in this round of 16. Sultan trying to get to the byline. Good block by Zurabayev, to concede the corner.
It's a lovely ball into Jalilov. First touch is good. He knows he's being caught. That is a good sprawling save and good reaction to stand up quickly. Concussion or not?
Well, they could be three up. Tajikistan, they've had the two best chances in the second half. Khalid has denied them on both occasions. They've got a corner though, UAE. Another poor delivery into the near post, easily cleared away. Messing beaten in the air by Fabio Lima. Zabi and Nasser. Nasser again. Sultan. Having to go back and across field more than forwards, UAE. He's playing up. Gone back to a back five with Mabachuev dropping back as well now. Alzabi. There by Nazarov. Not very far though. Pressure still on the Tajikistan defence. There's going to be a double change for UAE coming up in a moment. Well defended again. Nazarov. Jalilov rides the challenge. He's got players left and right. Essen to his left. Samiyev racing through the middle. Jalilov continues his run as well. It's a lovely ball. Jalilov cleared off the line by Nasser, still under pressure. And Samiyev couldn't get across to try and get a touch on that one. But Jalilov close to another goal again here for Tajikistan.
They had a 3-on-2 break and didn't make the most of it. Jalilov was having a go at his teammates earlier on. He's had two huge chances.
Nazarov. There's a push on Jalilov by Alhamadi. Samiyev caught, was he? The referee's only given a throw-in, I think. Samiyev has gone down, but he's off the pitch. Now the changes will be made. Ali Salah coming on. It was Nasser who wasn't aware that Sami was behind him, I don't think.
Did well on Nasser. Knew that was the only angle Jalilov was going to beat his keeper up front. And does really well. Doesn't quite catch it. If he gets a little dink and a full inside of the foot on that, I think it'll have enough to go over.
Well, the man who came on in the first half, Al Minhali, has made way. Ali Salah has come on. And Sultan has gone off. Khalid Al-Hanhani from Sharjah comes on for a 15th international appearance for UAE.
That's an awkward landing, that, for Safarov. Ali Salah's come in and just made a back for him. Landed awkwardly on his shoulder from a big height. That's no fun.
But he has got a Scottish mother. Ali Salah said he'd love to play in Scotland one day, or in England, the Premier League, given the chance. Currently at Al Wasl. He's 17 games without a goal in all competitions, so now would be a good time to try and break that duck to get UAE back into this one.
You do wonder if Tajikistan will regret those missed chances, because the pressure is going to keep on coming at them.
A two-goal cushion at this stage of the game would be a massive boost for Petr Sagan into the final half an hour of the round of 16 match. Numbers to support the UAE, but at the moment the side are trailing by a goal to nil. Hananov. There's Mabachuev. Gives the ball away cheaply for a throw into the UAE. Over on that far side. So round of 16 in the last edition, UAE came past the Kyrgyz Republic 3-2. They needed extra time in that one to come through. went on to beat Australia in the quarterfinals before bowing out to Qatar. Good ball down the line, but too much on it again for Yahia, who switched over to this near side since the introduction of Ali Salah.
What's he got on the bench? How much of his players given so far? Can they keep it tight? Will his knees stand up to him kneeling down on the edge of the technical area? Questions galore for Peter Sekert and Tajikistan, but at the moment, leading by a goal to nil.
I'm surprised he has any voice left at the end of a match, because he does shout. There's a lot of noise in these stadiums as well. It is quite difficult sometimes for the coaches to get their points across. This is Hananov. Gets applause there from Essen for playing the ball into the corner, but it has handed possession back. Hananov's goal coming 31 minutes in, separating the two sides here at the Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium in Al Rayyan.
Really should be more, really should be more.
Don't forget, two more round of 16 matches for you tomorrow. Iraq against Jordan from the Khalifa Stadium is the early game, and then the host nation, Qatar, taking on Palestine at Al Bayt, that wonderful venue. And the furthest venue north out of Doha. Australia already into the quarterfinals. Who is joining them from this one? Ali Salah just allowed that one to run. I think that went out of play. Off Safarov, so it will be a UAE throw. Yahia. Fabio Lima almost caught in possession. They're still working exceptionally hard, Tajikistan.
Fabio Lima's dropped into a more creative position. Genuine number 10.
Good touch from Ali Salah. And I think that's just been kept in by Safarov. It'll be a throw-in in the corner rather than a corner. Salah looking to put himself around since coming on. He's won a corner this time.
He's added a certain something, Ali Salah.
Possible players around the penalty spot. Misses everybody. Bounces over Hananov. Essen. Just caught, was he, by Al-Hanhani. Referee allowed play to go on. It's gone through to Halid, who's out of his area. Jalilov has gone down. He spoke to Petr Sagan a moment or so ago, who I think asked him if he wanted to be substituted. He's obviously picked up some kind of knock here, Jalilov. He's back on his feet. Al-Hanhani, Yahia, Fabio Lima. They are preparing the change, I think. Tajikistan. Ali Salah. Whipped in again. Hananov's there once more.
He's been brilliant.
Good delivery. Helped on its way by Essen, back on defensive duty. Goes out of you here. So good work again by Essen and Nazarov down this near side.
They defend very cleverly. Essen is dropping in to make sure there isn't that overload that nearly caught them out a couple of times in the first half on the opposite side. Mabachev is doing exactly the same job. Thinking defensive work first. No replacement for Jalilov yet.
Samiev just ducking underneath that one. Petr Sagan just urging his defenders to get higher up the field. UAE throw. Keo Canado comes across to this near side. It was Nazarov's header. Al-Hanhani. Happy to go back deep into their own half here at UAE and stop building from zero. Yahia.
It's hard at this stage not to think about who's not available for UAE and what they miss with Ali Maqgoud and his natural replacement on the bench. Or not on the bench, which is the problem.
Give it away cheaply again. Nazarov striding forward. Oh, loses out. Be a free kick to Yahia, who was just snapping at his heels a little. Goes into the book. First yellow card of the game.
That's really cynical. That's one of those where I've always thought football authorities could, it is so professional, it is so deliberate. It deserves a bigger sanction than a normal foul and a normal yellow card without being a red card.
Looks like they are going to make a change here. Tajikistan, it's an attacking one as well. Halid just plucks that ball out of the air comfortably. Rustam is going to come on and he's started the first three games.
Halid have to adjust very, very quickly then, because it made a step forward, and when the ball powered in towards him, he had to take a couple of quick steps back.
Almost brought under control by Canada, who had his back to goal. Cleared away once again. Sign of what UAE are missing with Ali Mabhout when you consider his record. Sixth in the list of all-time international goal scorers, and the only person in the top 10 with a better goal-scoring ratio per match is Ferenc Puskas, which is not a bad person to be beaten by. But he's not playing. He could have been the difference. Chase on here for Samiyev, who's still full of running. He's done well to get away from his man Nasser as well. Samiyev coming forward. Jalilov arriving! Oh, what a chance! He's put it wide. He's had so many chances in this second half, Jalilov. Samiyev did brilliantly. Nasser committed himself, he put it on a plate, and Jalilov has hit it wide.
That is the clearest chance of the lot. He's done really well to get into position. Nothing happens, it doesn't skip, it doesn't bounce. He's just got to get a good side foot. It maybe has come off his shin. This will be the great angle, but Samiyev, wonderful. He's down with cramp at the moment, but that's fabulous centre forward. And as it came off the shin, oh, what a huge chance.
Well, Rustam is coming on. Kamrakulov is also coming on. Brilliant from Samiyev. Samiyev is the player coming off. So Rustam comes off, and Jalilov, who we thought may have picked up an injury as well, comes off. Hamrolikov is the man that's coming on. Kamrolikov, who got that second goal in the win over Lebanon. Well, a daring to dream now, those Tajikistan fans. We've seen a lot of late goals in this AFC Asian Cup, and there will be considerable added time, you would feel. But Kamrokulov, who only made his debut back in 2021, comes on, hasn't been a regular over the last couple of years, but can do a job. And Rustam Soyrov, who plays for FC Lokomotiv in Uzbekistan, the man who'd started the last three games, he's another centre-forward in similar vein to Samiyev. And he will probably feel a little hard done by that he hasn't managed to find the net yet. Another change for UAE, Yahia has come off, and Majid Rashid comes on, having started two of the three group games for the UAE.
Paolo Bento is having to change his tactics as the game is going on. As we said, they've reached 70 minutes now, Tajikistan, and they're still holding UAE out.
Well played, Yatimov again. He took out Hananov, I think, but well, that was good goalkeeping. Don't matter what's in front of you, just be brave. Hananov's back to his feet. The referee will just check on him because it is a head injury, but, well, I say goalkeeper shouldn't worry about what's in front of them. Yatimov did just that.
That is twice Yatimov has come out and clobbered Hanenov. Must be a late call because Hanenov hasn't pulled out of the header clearance. He's okay, but he's saying he doesn't want any treatment. But to be consistent, referee Arai said, I did this for the UAE goalkeeper Khalid Issa in the first half. You've got to get a bit of attention now as well.
38 places separate these sides in the FIFA rankings. Tajikistan on very much an upward trend under Petr Sagan.
Hanenov still not being allowed to get onto the pitch. Now he is. Sprints back.
Nasser. Followed by Babachev. Just over a quarter of an hour to go. There'll be some nerves down on that Tajikistan bench. Hanenov's there with another stooping header to take that one away from Ali Salah. Concedes the corner, so a bit more pressure here for Tajikistan to absorb. Ali Salah will swing over the corner. Into the near post, away by Safarov. Defended the set pieces well so far, Tajikistan. There's some tired legs out there. They are playing a lot of games, of course. This is their fourth game in 10, 11 days. A little bit less than that. Chase on here for Rustam. As they're coming together with Rashid. Referee just allows play to continue. Just a coming together between the two of them.
Credit to Tajikistan, of course, for their defensive solidity, but also credit to UAE. They are just continuing to come forward. They're trying to use the full width of the pitch to wing backs, but that's not a good ball. They've got to believe one chance will come.
33,584 inside the Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium for this one. Another fantastic crowd in a tournament that will soon pass the 1 million mark for the first time in the AFC Asian Cup. There's Rustam. Nicely helped on Essen. Last-ditch challenge there by Rashid, who's having to cover plenty of ground since coming on just a moment or so ago, but he has conceded a corner. Essen to take this one. They are still getting the big men forward here, Tajikistan. There's no doubt that they'd like a second goal. They've had their chances. What can they do from the set piece? Their fifth corner of the game, and it comes, took a header. Flick header off Hamrolikov, the substitute.
He just glances that. If he gets a full head on that, that's a goal. Maybe put off by Hanenov in front of him. He actually twists his neck. So he's actually going to try and direct that into the corner. This could be 4 or 5 for Tajikistan. But while it's 1, it still remains very, very open.
Well, they've certainly had their chances. They were stopped playing, really, and stifled by Qatar in that second game. But here they've played with that brand of football that we saw for the first time against China. Rustam on the chase again. Now Hamidi will get their first back to Khalid. No time to think about the clearance. Nasser had an arm out. I think he hit him a little bit too high up the arm, though, but under pressure from Abachuev. And the throwing goes the way of a UAE.
Two little calls going against Tajikistan then. Number one, the handball, which, like you, I thought it had hit the top of his arm. And then a free kick given for what seemed to be a decent tackle.
By Canada, Yahia. Ali Salah. Weaving his way through, side netting, just the wrong side of the post from Ali Salah.
Yatimov was struggling here, you know. He was caught out through the legs. Well, no, Yatimov pulls out. I thought he'd gone down, but it was the pulling away of the arm. And cramp. As you say, it's been tight for Tajikistan. Played their first game on 13th of Jan. And they're all big international games. They're very tiring, emotionally draining. Well, you said nine of the players played right the way through.
UAE supporters will be anxiously looking at watches, and it will tell them there's under 12 minutes to go here plus stoppage time. Came here with high expectations, of course, after their performance in the UAE 5 years ago. Had a pretty good qualifying campaign for this. They only lost two games in the second round of World Cup qualification to Thailand and Vietnam. Only made it to one World Cup finals, the UAE. That was back in 1990, that famous Italia 90 World Cup, when they failed to make it past the group stages. Qualification underway, of course, for the next World Cup, the expanded edition. So UAE, one of the nations that they hope will maybe work in their favour. They've already beaten Nepal and Bahrain in qualifying. It's going to go out to Ali Salah for a goal kick.
Hananov did brilliantly. That ball was played over the top for Ali Salah, and it looked like he was going to have some space thrown into, and Hananov, it looks routine, but his pace gets him behind the fullback and forces the error. Quite a few of the Tajik players showing signs of cramp, fatigue. You're seeing not so much Kramrokhilov, but certainly Shukarov in the heart of midfield. He stopped for cramp a couple of times.
That's where the game management comes in. And the coaching staff knowing when to make those changes and use them sparingly. Of course, five changes can change half your outfield lineup. This is Al Handani. Took a slight deflection, goes for a corner off Zurabayev,
who, as usual, has defended wonderfully, as well as setting up the only goal of the game. But he's got some defending to do here in this Fabio Lima corner.
The post by Fabio Lima, once again it's cleared away. Majid. Shot was blocked again, Rustam. Forced cross field, pursued by Al Hamadi. Ali Salah there, double teaming him to win the ball back for UAE. There's two balls on the field, so the referee will just restart with a uncontested drop ball. It doesn't really make too much difference to the situation with Nasser on the ball.
Omar Boev is saying he needs to be changed. He is struggling with cramp. The two central midfielders have done so much running.
Well, you need your fittest players on when you're certainly going to be under pressure for the remainder of this game. Al Hamadi forward, Yahia. Stops, checks, and finds Ali Salah, pressed by Shukarov. Al Hamadi, Al Zabi, three UAE shirts on that far side. Offside flags up, wouldn't have counted. Yatimov made a good save, but the flag was straight up on this near side against Yahia. And they're frantically signalling to the bench here. There's another player gone down as well. Umabayev down, there's a player down in the penalty area with cramp as well. That just shows the effort that these players have exuded over the 82 minutes that we've played so far.
With so many players struggling, and yeah, Nazarov is saying there's a need to change. I think it's Safarov who's down over on the far side. So that's the right back who's been really, really good, but Ali Salah has taken him to the cleaners a couple of times, gun short, and then received the ball over the top of Safarov.
That's whoever's the player down inside the penalty area. Have made two changes already, Tajikistan, so of course they still have to be mindful that there could be extra time and there could be penalties, and if you lose some of your penalty takers as well, they won't be thinking that too far ahead at the moment, but it has to come into play. I'm sure Petr Sagan wanted to save maybe a couple of his changes.
Paolo Bento with the stern look. And he always seemed to have a stern look. Jumabayev patched up. Oh, Isan blocked off. Yeah, there's an Aaron's arm there. Isan cleverly walked into it, but there was an arm out.
Well, Zabi not happy and gets a yellow card for his reaction, and he would miss the next game if UAE do go through. It's his second yellow.
He's been angry with the referee for quite a while. A couple of shouts at the ref in the first half. Now the changes are coming, and not surprisingly, Umabayev is one of the ones coming off.
Tabrez is coming on. Mohamed John is also coming on. Mabachuev goes off, and Umabayev goes off. Rustam. First touch for Tabrez. Flag was up for offside though. And who's just come on?
Long way offside. Well, the fresh legs, have they come on in time?
Hananov's header. Kaya Canada trying to go through the gap, but closed off once again by those white-shirted UAE players. Flag stays down this time. Rustam taking on El Hamadi. Still going Rustam, waiting for support. Gets the corner. Very, very close. He went early. There's a bit of cramp here for El Hamadi as well.
El Hamadi did well. He's got that extra little bit of pace. Got him into a good position to defend this from Rustam.
Swinger from Essen. There are four players staying back now. Good height on that one. Halley just helps it away. Nicely done. Ali Salah. Now can they break here with those white shirts streaming back? Hills Zalzabi, the man who was booked a moment or so ago. Fabio Lima. Al-Henhani. Shirts are very quickly regrouped from that corner.
Nazarov was key for that. He closed down on Alzabi, prevented any more forward momentum, forced Alzabi backwards, and that allowed his teammate to get back into position.
Poor touch by Ali Salah. Kept in play by Al-Henhani. Good defending. Nazarov. Leading by example, the Tajikistan captain. Paolo Bento on the edge of his technical area. Hands in pockets, not much he can do at the moment to influence things on the field. Here comes the ball again, it's over everybody. Safarov just failed to get a touch. Fortunately, goes for a goal kick. And the coaches between them just wondering how they could get back into this one at this late stage of the game, as are those supporters massed behind Yatimov's goal.
When that cross came in, I was thinking, Ali Maghout, where are you? That would be meat and drink for the star striker. And the longer this game goes goalless, the more his absence is felt.
Al-Hamadi. By Halid. Zurabayev. Just get the ball away from danger, you feel would be the brief now for Tajikistan. Of course, UAE will commit playing forward. It may play into the hands of Rustam and Hamrukulov.
Oh, Rustam. Well, the front two have been replaced by a similar duo, but there's fresh legs there now.
Hadanov won the header from Kayo Canado. Quick two. High five, and let me just apologise for a slight use of the arm, but no foul.
Man of the match, absolutely. Hadanov, not only for the goal is a wonderful bonus, but his team have still got to hold on.
Well, I certainly think he's been one of the defenders of the tournament so far, and when that team of the tournament is announced, I'm sure Hadanov will certainly be in the frame. 90 seconds plus stoppages to go for the UAE to save their AFC Asian Cup campaign here in Qatar. They trail by that goal from Hadanov. 31 minutes when the header found its way in past Khalid. Here's Al Hanhani. Ali Salah making ground along the front line. He has switched to play a more fluid role now, Ali Salah. But once again, forced backwards by those white shirts. Al Hanhani, Al Hamadi, Nasser. UAE felt themselves lucky that they're still in the game. Took it to those chances that Tajikistan had. It's cleverly done from Zurabayev, just get the ball out of play.
Is it the Tajikistan that had 16 minutes of time added on? Gosh. Imagine if that board goes up and says another double-digit number.
And they're checking for a possible penalty here. Handball possibly by Umabayev just there. No, I think it hit the top of his arm and then missed the forearm. It'd be very harsh again. We had one looked at in the first half, which would have been harsh if given.
Well, they're still checking the penalty. And then if they check long enough, they come over to the match official and say, what do you think? 7 minutes is the time added on.
No penalty. So it would have been a harsh one. Looks as if the ball just grazed the arm maybe, but there's 16 minutes added time Tajikistan had in their third group game against Lebanon. It was a nervy, nervy time. That ball bobbling around awkwardly. Again, there's another big appeal. Ball curled in off the inside of the post. What a chance. The closest they've come to an equaliser. Play continues. Al-Zarbi, another player goes down injured. Essen, no foul. Again, says the referee. Zabi just writes the challenge. What a grandstand finish we'll have here. Al Hanhani, Hananov's there again with a clearance away, helped on by Shukarov. Yahia. Curl back in again. High one into Kayo Canedo. But it should be easily dropped and easily allowed to run behind for a goal kick. But what a chance for UAE.
This was the moment that maybe, maybe Tajikistan have earned. Was there a handball then? Fabio, Ghassani, he does this beautifully. There's so many bodies and he just curls it into space. That is so unfortunate.
Well, he was the man who got the goal that got them back into their last match against Iran and effectively put them back above Palestine into second, which is why they ended up playing Tajikistan. Could have easily finished in third spot, gone on to face Qatar, the host nation, tomorrow. What a moment this will be for Tajikistan. First ever AFC Asian Cup. By Muhammadjon. Good play again. Those fresh legs just over on that far side, just helping to block out the threat of Ali Salah. Al Hamadi. Al Zabi. Fabio Lima. He's a bit of quality, a little bit of flair. This man also almost provided it a moment or so ago. Here's ball in, Yatimov there again, just did enough to take it away from Fabio Lima, and they gather at the feet of Vicinato rather than gather defeat of Fabio Lima. Good goalkeeping once again.
Nothing wrong with that from Canedo. Yatimov does well, and because he has two hands going for it, he's able to be in the right position when it bounces, fortunately for him. A couple of big moments of fortune, though, for Tajikistan. They're hanging on, but they've only got to hang on for another 3.5 minutes.
The prize for the winners. A round of a quarter-final match against either Iraq or Jordan. Rustam tussling away, gives away the free kick for the foul on Rashid. There's a bit of urgency, as you would imagine, about the UAE now. Al Hamadi. Yahir outside him. Pace on the ball. That's a trip off the ball. It's a clumsy one because I don't think Yahir would have got that ball. Mistake by Mohamed John.
He puts his arms up. It is a foul. It's unnecessary pressure. And you're quite right. Safarov was there. Well, that looks like Yaya did exaggerate it, but the pressure will be incessant. You want your goalkeeper to dominate.
Ali Salah whips it in with pace! And the goalkeeper hasn't dominated because UAE are back on level terms. It looked as though it was El Hamadi that got the final touch. The pace on the ball from Ali Salah was just helped on its way. And deep into added time, UAE have broken Tajikistan's hearts. It's 1-1.
It's a really good header. It's a wonderful free kick. It beats the first man. And as you say, it was helped on by Al Hamadi. Oh, it's so cruel for Tajikistan. But a terrific ball in. Just gets there ahead of Hananov. And Yatimov, nothing he can do about that. Finds the corner. They pressed and they pressed. Ali Salah has made the difference. It's a fantastic floated free kick in. And for all their pressure, they've deserved it. But Tajikistan, those chances they missed, they do come back to haunt them.
Well, just a second international goal for Khalifa Al Hamadi. And what a time to score it as well. We say if you deliver quality into the box, you will reap the rewards. And that's exactly what has happened. It's the best free kick or best set piece we've seen all night from Ali Salah. And it's levelled things up at 1-1. VAR might just be having a check, which is over, so the goal stands. And we are just a couple of minutes away now from an extra 30. Hamadi. Well, there's a spring in the step now of the UAE. That's Yahir who goes down. Corner given away off Hananov, so still some work to do here for Tajikistan. We've played the 7 minutes. Ali Salah once again over the set piece.
And they've sent everybody forward. They're chasing a winner.
Came off Hananov. Won't drop. Surely that's offside. It was
a hand.
Yeah, a handball, I think. But certainly looked like an offside would have been given, I think, there if that ball had have ended up in the back of the net. What a grandstand finale we've had here. Well, there's more to come, it would appear.
You know what, he might have been onside if that was allowed. Oh, but Tajikistan have given everything and they have to pick themselves up once again. Start all over again. Without their creative forces.
Yeah, such was the efforts that they'd given. Lost several players through injury, cramp or muscle issues. But there's a spirit about them, you know that they will give their all.
And the spirit about Tajikistan as well.
Well, here they come, three waiting in the middle. Flying header, good save, Halid! And Rolikov, who scored in stoppage time in the last match, scores his fourth. A brilliant save from the goalkeeper, Halid.
That is going top corner. Goalkeeper does well not to step away to his right. Defends that near post.
Essen with the corner. This could well be the last kick of the match. Who knows? Five players wait. No height on the delivery. Another corner. Needs to get it away from that first man.
A little bit of naughtiness involving Ali Salah. He's having a go at Jurabayev. UAE not happy that we're 2 minutes into time added on.
Five players in white inside the penalty area. Needs a better delivery this time from Essen. He's driven it in flat. And UAE should be able to get this one clear with Fabio Lima. Well, there goes the whistle. UAE have left it late, but they have got themselves an extra 30 minutes, potentially penalties, of course, here to try and see themselves through to the quarterfinals. Extra time is on the way. It's finished Tajikistan 1, United Arab Emirates 1 at the Ahmed Bin Ali. Another 30 minutes awaits.
It was always a danger that UAE would be able to force the game. Tajikistan were tired. A couple of players went off with cramp. They defended so well with such a small group of players throughout this whole tournament that the pressure eventually just told. It was a lovely ball in by Ali Salah. His introduction down the left-hand side, absolutely fundamental.
Well, what a game we've had here at Ahmed Bin Ali. Tajikistan have pressed and they have looked really good in this game. Essen forcing a save from Halid in the second half that just turned behind for a corner. They led 1-0. Hananov got the goal in the first half, and UAE guilty of giving the ball away. And how they rue these missed chances now. It was Jalilov that was through, but another good save by Halid.
Halid was busier, and Tajikistan, this was the moment, this is the big moment for Jalilov. Look at him, he runs into space, the cross is perfect, the finish at 2-0, that is the match won. And we wondered if that would be come back to really haunt them.
And they were having to defend at times, they survived a couple of penalty shouts. Right at the end of the game though, it was Yahia that hit the inside of the post and the ball rebounded to safety. But then the moment that took us to extra time, free kick whipped in by Ali Salah, and a flick header from Al-Hamadi beyond Yatimov. And what was that, 5 minutes into added time, the equaliser came. Quality on the ball in, and a quality header just to guide it into the back of the net.
Hananov so close to getting there, but Hananov did well. But even then, it wasn't over.
A flying header from distance from Hamronikov, one of the substitutes for Tajikistan, forcing Halid into a fine save. And an extra 30 minutes is on the way. Well, it's been a great occasion here. There'll be some tired legs out there. They can tell you that it may not be as hot as it can be here in Qatar, but it still is energy sapping. 33,500 spectators inside this wonderful stadium. And Paolo Bento knows his side have been given a second chance and a little bit of a lifeline here going into a final 30 minutes. But I don't think either side, Des, will want this to go down to a penalty shootout.
No, they won't. But UAE, they'll have the boost of that late equaliser. They were pressing. They'd hit the inside of the post. They had a couple of penalty shouts. They did have Tajikistan on the back foot, particularly after that final Jalilov miss where he put it wide. He had two one-on-ones with the goalkeeper prior to that. One saved off the line, one well saved by the goalkeeper. But the big one was when he fired the cross that came in beautifully from Samiev. He fired it wide. And now, well, Peter Seghert has got motivational powers, but I'm not sure he's got the personnel on the field for extra time, Mark, for them to really be able to cause the problems that they did in the first 75 minutes.
Well, both teams are allowed to make an extra substitution, of course, as we've gone into extra time. UAE have made three of their substitutions, four changes made by Tajikistan. Alida Nazarov going to flip the coin again for the second time in the match. 30 minutes, 15 minutes each way then to come. Tajikistan 1, UAE 1, and all of a sudden those UAE supporters sense that this could be their moment to get through to the quarterfinals. Beaten in the semi-finals 5 years ago in the UAE. This is where Paolo Bento and Petr Seghert will both do their work with the team talk.
He tried just about everything in the game, changed his tactics, put on wing-backs, withdrew Fabio Liemer into an attacking midfield role. All kinds of changes from Paolo Bento, so he shuffled his pack as much as he possibly could. And he got the reward. But Tajikistan, you miss your chances. And of course, it'll come back to bite you in the cruelest, cruelest of ways. What a contribution they made to the 90 minutes. Can they pick themselves up again for the next 30? It'll be incredibly difficult to do so.
Just waiting the UAE players to come back out here. Which side will have the more stamina? Which side will have the more staying power to go through this 30 minutes? Another change being made by the UAE. We're going to see Salmin coming on to replace Alzaabi, who's on a yellow card. He will miss the next match anyway, so Salmin could well be a potential replacement for him if they go through. Yusuke Naraki is the referee who's refereed this pretty well. A couple of yellow cards kept the game flowing nicely, and a couple of VAR interventions, but nothing that has mattered too much. Petr Seghert, well, I'm sure he'll be proud of his team, whatever the result here, but will feel that they've had the opportunities to get this one sewn up. It is UAE that we've gone back to the way we were in the first half, so UAE kicking from right to left at the start of the first period of extra time.
With extra time, you can utilise an extra sub as well. The substitutions that Tajikistan have, I don't think can add the quality, but they'll add fresh legs, and maybe it's a case of keep it down.
Well played by Safarov under pressure from Yahia Talhamdi. Shukarov through the gap looking for the Jason Mohamedjian. Well defended by those two UAE central defenders, Nasser and Alhamadi.
He's quick, Alhamadi. He's rescued his team a couple of times.
Oh, he's given away by Ali Salah. Solid challenge from Rashid, which has left Mohamedjian down. The referee pulls it back for the free kick, tried to allow the play to run, but no advantage.
Scissors on the back ankle. That'll be a sore one for Mohamedjian Rahimov.
He's been competitive in that central midfield area, Rashid, since coming on. Everybody back behind the ball here for UAE. Just complaining that Ali Salah's not back the full 10 yards here. Hassan is over the free kick. It's an interesting one. Took a deflection low down. Ball bobbling around. It came off Safarov and fell through to the goalkeeper. Made a couple of important saves in that second half. Khalid, feared for him, of course, after that bang on the head when Hadanov scored and he hit his head off the post, but recovered suitably to prove a good last line of defence for the UAE that second half. Safarov.
The one right at the end from Khomrokhilov was particularly impressive and important.
Hamidi's header. Ali Salah. Just flicked over the top for Kayo Canedo. And a tussle with Hadanov and winning the ball away from Hadanov as well. It's Canedo. Good block from Zurabayev. Hesitation from Shukarov has allowed the ball back for the UAE, plucked out of the air there by Yatimov with Fabio Lima just behind him.
Hadanov and Zurabayev have been utterly outstanding.
Khalid forced to come off his line quickly. Rustam. Salah. Free kick to the UAE. Petr Sagat absolutely furious on the sidelines.
Well, his energy levels haven't dropped and he's maybe trying to set an example to his team. We won the game once, as it was famously said once in a World Cup final. Let's go out and win it again.
Salmon. Over the top for Yahia. Just kept that one in play. Gordon whipped him once again. Zurabayev forced to concede the corner. Gets the applause from Paolo Bento.
Number of crosses that Zurabayev and Hadanov have picked up. When it's come into the penalty area, they've defended their penalty area wonderfully. Apart from that late equaliser.
Ali Salah over the corner. Yatimov opts to punch once again, but does get good distance on the ball. Mohamedjon spreading the play out here to Essen. Essen long way out, but got right underneath that one over the top. Nothing much on in front of him, so opting to go for goal, but well off target.
Rather telegraphed his intentions a long way out here. He has got the ability, but he's just put under pressure at the last second and rather snatches at it. But Tajikistan, they've got back into their regimented ways, their 4-4-1-1.
Too much on that, gets him off comfortable. Shukarov. Essen again. Slowing this right down now. Tajikistan. Forward by Essen. It was another good header by Alhamadi. Given away to Safarov. Just ran into his opposite number there, Salmin. Yahia. Good quick feet. Ali Salah's outside him if he needs him. Mohamedjon gets in first.
Needed to release that earlier. Ali Salah did have a little bit of space.
Canedo. Well played. Shukarov in that midfield area. Good ball as well. Pressing the accelerator from Rustam, but an even faster move from Alhamadi to get the ball away from him, but he's won it back. Here's Rustam. Mohamedjon. Rustam, not quite what was required. It's hooked away by Al-Hedhani.
You won't beat Al-Mohamadi for pace.
Overcomes the cross again. Good take by Halid. No doubt about his fitness in the second half and into this period of extra time. Rashid.
I think Tajikistan would take penalties. They're not necessarily playing for them, but I think their first thought for now is not to concede. And if they can break, they're not breaking with five and six players, it's only with three.
Nasser. Al-Hamadi. Rashid. Pace of the game has slowed down considerably from the last, 15, 20 minutes of the 90.
It had to. It was frantic, certainly from UAE.
We said about game management as well, and the last thing anybody would want would to make a silly mistake because they're over pressing themselves late on in the game. That's a nodded down to Fabio Lima. Just enough in there in terms of a deflection from Essen. Back out to Salmin. UAE just patient in the build-up. Salmin. Long way out, but he tries his luck, and again, similar to the effort at the other end a moment or so ago, flies way over the top.
He was encouraged to shoot. I've not seen him score from 30 yards, but clearly many of the UAE fans think he has. Paolo Bento's not particularly impressed with that effort.
They still believe, those Tajikistan supporters. Great to see teams' colours adorned almost everywhere you go in. Qatar, banners in the shopping malls and lots of branding and advertising for this tournament. There's a foul on Rustam, who's lost a boot in the process.
Caught on the back of the heel as he jumps up. I don't think that was a deliberate one, but it is an old centre-half trick, just to stand on the back of the heels. Not nice. Remarkable energy, remarkable group of players that he's put together.
Drop ball in favour of UAE. Rustam only scored his first international goal in that Merdeka Cup final. Knocked away by Nasser.
And Riyad Mohammadjan Rahimov has a role to play here. He's a bit like Jalilov, lovely creative player. Needs to put the work that Jalilov did before he was taken off. Wasn't strong enough there.
Peter Sagat still urging greater efforts from his team. 3.5 minutes to go with the first period of extra time. Nasser. There's Al-Hamadi. By Halid. Straight out of play though.
Very wasteful. Maybe there's some fatigue in this UAE team as well.
Paolo Bento turned away in frustration as well when that ball went out of play. Throw in to be taken by Safarov. Poor touch from Essen. Ali Salah. Oh, Hananov and Kaya Canedo just having a little coming together. Referee saw nothing untoward. Hananov felt he should have had a free kick, but ball's back with his goalkeeper, Yatimov.
We'd expected UAE to try and really kick on with the momentum of the late equaliser.
Going over the top, just too far ahead of Rustam. We did mention that UAE needed extra time to beat Kyrgyz Republic. We're in the round of 16 in 2019. 3-2 on that occasion. Also won their last penalty shootout as well back in 2015 when they beat Japan in the quarterfinals. Still another 15 minutes plus to go before we can think about a penalty shootout. Forward by Nasser, guided on by Yahia. Hananov's there again, just left the ball behind though, and we'll get away with that with the goal kick under pressure from Alhamadi.
He's involved in conversations with the UAE players all over. He's just put on a little kiss here to Alhamadi, as if to say, I'm in control of that. He's had one or two hugs with Kyle Canedo. Character as well as a key player.
Most clearance. Good header from Rashid. Yahia. Kyle Canedo's in behind Hananov this time. Umabai have the last line of defence, though, stabs the ball out for a corner. If one doesn't get there, the other one invariably does.
They do, they play very, very close together. That's wonderful from Zoya Jurabayev.
Corner for Ali Salah to deliver. His free kick led to the equalising goal. What could he do with this one? Goes right the way across, takes another deflection off a Tajikistan player, another corner.
Tabrez celebrates it. But he plays a lovely ball in, Ali Salah. Flat at pace. One or two people were saying that the ball isn't the easiest to hit in that manner, but Ali Salah is certainly finding a way.
All the way across to the other side, Ali Salah. That's what awaits him in the middle. Good ball in, aimed in towards Alhamadi again, who got the equaliser. He's gone down injured, maybe a touch of cramp inside the six-yard box, so they're going to be one short at the back here. UAE, if Tajikistan can get the ball forward. But the referee blows the whistle for half-time. In extra time, Alhamadi looks in some discomfort. I think it is just cramp as he went flying in to try and get on the end of that header. But halfway through the extra time, it's Tajikistan 1, United Arab Emirates 1 still.
Alhamadi still on the floor being helped. Glad to see that good sportsmanship there from Rustam Yatimov. Once it's extra time, the emotion of the previous 90 minutes somehow seems to dissipate in that little 5-minute break between full-time and the start of extra time. And now you're just digging in, getting liquids on, getting salt into your system if you possibly can. And you said in commentary earlier, Mark, you don't want to make a mistake. That, the longer the game goes on, that becomes more and more part of what we're thinking.
Relax, relax, relax is the message from Petr Sagat. Substitutes helping out with the stretching as well. Shukarov just having those calves and hamstrings stretched. They won't want to suffer any more injury problems in this second period of extra time. UAE have dominated the possession. 11 efforts on target between the two teams as well. Goalkeepers have been called into action on a number of occasions. See the tiredness is just creeping into the legs now. That first period of extra time was certainly slower in terms of pace of the game, as you would expect.
UAE still very much the favourites, despite the number of changes, the number of fresh legs that are on. UAE have had more of the ball, as you said. It's two-thirds of the possession. Alhamadi has just recovered from his bout of cramp. But it did look so severe, you wonder whether or not he's going to be able to continue.
He's still hobbling. Just had a few words with Halid, the goalkeeper. So 15 minutes to go in this second round of 16 match of the day. Are we going to be decided inside 120 minutes, or are we going to need the drama of a penalty shootout here? Iraq or Jordan awaiting the winners. They play tomorrow. Qatar against Palestine. Can the host nation go on to retain their AFC Asian Cup this edition? All will be revealed over the next 2.5 weeks or so. 2 weeks or so. Rustam almost fell for him on the edge of the area. Handball by Rustam as it almost fell to Hamroukalov.
Hamajon being asked to play the big number nine role. It's not what he likes to do. It's a bit unfortunate when it comes off the arm. Good defensive play once again.
Alhamadi. So a slightly dangerous ball when your fellow central defender's just come back from cramp. Get away with it though. Nasser. It's a pass to no one, and I think that will be the one thing that frustrates Paolo Bento, is just unnecessary giving the ball away with these unforced passes, really.
And he's not slow to show his displeasure. Here's Senor Bento.
By Salmin. Essen. It's a great ball, trying to stab that one through for Hamroukalov. Nice one-touch football there from UAE to play themselves out of trouble. Nice ball down the line as well by Alhamadi towards Ali Salah. Hananov has got there again. Just nudged off the ball by the substitute, who shows his displeasure and could be in trouble if referee deems that a little bit too aggressive towards him, but no yellow card.
Again, excellent from Hananov. Knows he's got nowhere to go, protects the ball, invites the little challenge in the back. It is a foul. Scottish in him.
Yatimov with the free kick. Rustam trying to get in between the two defenders. Who did that take a touch off? Off the Tajikistan striker, goal kick.
Hamajon getting the flick on. He really isn't a number nine, but he's operating like it, and he got there in between the two centre backs. And Rustam got to the ball first, couldn't control it.
There's a player down, Hamroukalov has stayed down. Ali Salah chases, pursued by Zurabayev. Shukarov hooks clear, referee will just come and check. There could be a head injury for Hamroukalov.
Doesn't look to be a lot of contact in that. Oh yes, just there. Kayo's shoulder into the back.
To Segert making the point that it is a head injury. Drew with Jordan in their first 2026 World Cup qualifier back in November before beating Pakistan by 6-1. Had an unofficial friendly in the UAE against Hong Kong, China before they came here. They won that 2-1 as well, so came into this in good form after that Madeka Cup win back in October, Tajikistan. But this is a different level when you're playing in the finals against teams of the experience of the UAE. did restrict Qatar in the second group game, 0-0 with China. But they certainly haven't disgraced themselves, Tajikistan, and they've played the game with a freshness and an enthusiasm that's been a delight to watch, really.
Wonderful. And with two key absentees from the squad coming into the tournament. Manucha Jalilov is their all-time top scorer. He is missing, so they've compensated for him. Kamilov down the right-hand side, he's been missed. He's suspended. If they do get through, be it in extra time or penalties, he'll be available. But I'd still have UAE down, providing that they can take the game to Tajikistan. I still have UAE down as clear favourite to take this, and they've got to take the initiative.
Nasser. Away by Khalid. Played by Tabrez, who just got in front of his man. Here's Essen. Rustam just slipped, got the ball caught under his feet, but managed to recover in time. Nazarov. Essen just let that go before Salmin could get a touch on it. Hananov. Down the line looking for the run of Amrukalov, who was the man who was having treatment a moment or so ago. Just managed to keep that ball in play. Stab forward. Mohammed John. Nasser, though, got there first. Safarov's header.
There's a bit more energy to this second period.
I think the magnitude is probably hitting that with every second that passes, we're getting closer to a penalty shootout. There'll be heroes, there'll be villains. Nobody wants to be the villain and cost their side a place. It is just down to a kick of the football, of course, and those tired legs will be playing a part in that. Here's Salmin. Kaya Canedo caught in possession, referee gives the free kick. So they'll take those, UAE. Elhenhani, another play again from Tabrez. I think we're going to be in for some tight round of 16 matches, and probably some tight quarter-final matches as well. History shows that there's a lot of games in this competition go to extra time when it gets to the knockout stages. Not too much to choose between the times, but this has been an entertaining matchup between these two.
That's been really good. UAE, to their credit, didn't give up. They did create that late equaliser. They rather ruined the story that everybody was writing in the headlines.
Yeah, those missed chances in the second half, particularly from Jalilov, mainly. A brilliant one after great work from Samiev. Good ball over the top. Rustam's on the chase. Nasser takes a tumble. He's all on his own here, though, Nasser. He's waiting for support, taking on Al-Hamadi. And in the end, it was Rashid who got the challenge in. Nasser recovered his position.
Rashid was never going to lose that one.
Rustam beaten again.
Such a strong, powerful presence, Rashid.
Played by Fabio Lima to win the ball back. And by Salmin. Keo Canedo. Well, good quick feet. Buying himself a little bit of space. Yahia. He's already hit the inside of the post. Goes for goal again. Yatimov, though, was there. Straight at him.
Wonderful from Keo Canedo, though. In the middle of the park. Strong enough to hold off two challengers. He and Fabio Lina in this last, 6 minutes or so, could still have a huge role to play for United Arab Emirates. They've got that little bit of extra quality.
Peter Sagat has dispensed with the jacket and trying to lift his side for that extra 10-15% effort that could get them over the line. 5.5 minutes to go.
Clobbered him. The ball is in the air. He's gone for the ball, but he has absolutely clobbered Alhamadi.
Yeah, Hamrukulov. And this doesn't look good at the moment. It was a heavy collision. Yellow card for Hamrukulov. It was a very, very hefty challenge. Well, they were preparing to go out of the competition until that equaliser came in stoppage time. Hamrukulov goes into the book.
He's got every right to go for the ball, but he's slightly late, and then the impact of his challenge, particularly as Alhamadi, he wasn't protecting himself. And this is another one of the ones, like the first half injury to Abdellah Ramadan, who I think UAE have missed. They've missed his influence in the heart of midfield. There will be some reasons why UAE haven't been dominating and firing on all cylinders, and that absence might be one. He had an injury that looked bad immediately, and this doesn't look too great either.
Well, they will know the UAE, if they do progress, they're going to need to come up with better performances going forward. And he's sitting up now, Alhamadi. We saw an injury to the goalkeeper in the first half. Here's the challenge. Straight into the side of Alhamadi.
Could be the kidney or the hip. It's that low down, exposed area. I don't think it's a head issue. It's we'll have to go off just for a few seconds. And that will mean there will be time added on at the end. Save another 5 minutes at the end of the extra time.
He's okay to continue, Alhamadi. Free kick to UAE, be taken by Khalid. Foul on Khalanov that time.
I think Khalanov's missed one header all game. Sadly, it led to the goal.
I don't think any defender in the world would have got to that header with the quality on that ball in from Ali Salah. Yatimov to launch this one long. Rashid's header, another free kick. Very stop-start in the second period of extra time. Fabio Lima. Alhamdani. Fabio Lima again was just pressured there by Rustam, but managed to retain possession. Ali Salah.
They want Lima on the ball more. He can create.
Nasser's ball in, just ducked underneath by Tabrez. There was no one behind him, had a shout, I'm sure.
It was a late shout. Ten-second delays here and there, as you'd expect from Yatimov. Takes the ball into the middle of the goal. There's another 3 or 4 seconds, then comes back to the left-hand side. I think Tajikistan would take penalties now.
Yeah, you have to take your chances and hope that it's you that could be proficient from the spot. Goalkeepers will have done their homework, of course. That's a good ball forward. Khalid just waited a moment for that to come in, and there was a late challenge on Essen, which I think the referee will pull back for a free kick.
Love the goalkeeper's starting position there. He was so far out anticipating the cross that what could have been a dangerous ball was intercepted by the goalkeeper on his just under his 18-yard line.
There's a yellow card for someone on the UAE bench here. The fourth official has just drawn the Japanese referee's attention to that. Complaining about the award of the free kick. Just caught late by Rashid after the ball had gone. Just caught on the follow through. Now, is this a chance? It's a little bit further out than the free kick that Ali Salah put in, but Essen has quality as well. Needs to get some whip on this towards the goalkeeper, Hananov. Trying to turn, but couldn't get the ball out of his feet, and then he subsequently fouls Caio Canedo. 4 minutes added time at the end of the second period of extra time. Peter Sagan urging his side to stay high and not give UAE any space going forward. We had a goal in stoppage time at the end of the 90. Can we get a goal here in stoppage time at the end of the 120? Khalid with the clearance. Zurabayev's header. Fabio Lima. Well played by Zurabayev. It was caught late after the ball had gone. Play continues though, Mohamed John. Referee played the advantage. Down the line for Rustam. Good challenge that time from Rashid.
He's been strong since he came on, Rashid. He's had to make a couple of last-gasp defensive blocks and tackles.
Throw in to be taken by Nazarov. Zurabayev. Nazarov. Into Rustam. Too much pace on it, though. Ali Salah clears away. Zurabayev heads forward again. Just too high for Essen. Wasteful. Gives possession back to Tajikistan from Shukarov. They want a ball, and now we have two. To Alhandani with the throw. Again, is there time for one more opportunity for either of these teams to win this one without the need for a penalty shootout?
The organisation in extra time for Tajikistan has been impressive. Going into the final 30 minutes, there only was going to be one winner, and Tajikistan have made sure that that prediction from me was completely wrong.
That's the beauty of this game. Gets him off, clears away yes again. Channel for Rustam to chase. I think that's gone for a corner. It was stabbed out by Alhandani. Probably didn't need to get a touch on that.
The Tajik players and substitutes, they cheered like that, like it was almost a goal. Arms are up and they see, wow. I can see the headlines. Yatimov is right out of his goal. Now he's heading back in.
They wanted to come out and up to support Rustam Yatimov, but he might still have work to do yet. Depends what Essen can do here with the delivery. Now they will challenge into the near post, cleared away once again. Nazarov, Essen, trying to get round Rashid, just slipped and lost his footing, and again a little bit of cramp creeping in as the referee's whistle goes to bring extra time to a close, and we are going to have a penalty shootout to find out who our second quarter-finalist will be. Half-time, after a thrilling period of extra time, it's finished Tajikistan 1, United Arab Emirates 1. A penalty shootout is on the way.
Congratulations to both teams. They really have given everything. Particular congratulations to Tajikistan. A, for the way they performed in the opening 90 minutes, and then to recover having been so cruelly robbed of a place in the quarter-final, then their reward is a penalty shootout, which is 50-50, and they will believe that they can make it to the last eight.
Well, there weren't too many clear-cut chances in extra time. Tajikistan did press, but it was solid defending in the end from the UAE. Khalid, who picked up that injury in the first half, showing no ill effects. UAE, who scored that late goal and saw Yahia hit the inside of the post. The ball whipped in, but once again, Zurabayev was there. That twin defensive partnership, Hananov and Zurabayev standing firm. Khalid plucking that ball away from Mohamed John, who was one of a number of substitutes. Kayo Canedo worked hard, but again, another good, well-timed tackle from Zurabayev. But you always felt there was a goal on the break in this, but it was down to two very good sets of defending. Kayo Canedo striding forward once again, but Tajikistan standing firm once more.
Standing firm is absolutely what it is. Yahya was probably the main man they could go for, but both teams were left out. They'd given everything. And we are going to a penalty shootout. And now, so long as you don't have cramp coming up, stick to your decision. That's what the coaches will say. Decide if you want to go left or right or down the middle, but don't change your mind. For goalkeepers, the chance to be a hero. For Yatimov, the chance, I think, to be a superhero, because UAE are expected to go through. And I think, as we said at the very start, Mark, for Tajikistan, they've already created history. They're just in the midst, perhaps, of creating a little bit more.
Well, for the third time, there'll be a coin toss between Nazarov and Khalid to decide
you can choose
who takes first.
First one. So UAE, second one, okay?
So it looks as though the toss was won by Tajikistan. So is that the first battle? I wonder. They will take the first penalty, which I think he's always an advantage to take first. Just a look at the two goalkeepers. Yatimov has saved two penalties in his career, saved one in the CAFA Nations Cup back in 2023 against Oman. His opposite number. Khalid has saved four penalties. He's already saved one in this competition against Palestine, so maybe he is the more informed goalkeeper in terms of a shootout. There's a big huddle of UAE players all with their arms together. It's only the players that finished on the field will be allowed to enter the centre circle for the penalty shootout. Credit to the referee as well, who has kept the game flowing. He's had a very good game. So Yatimov just waiting to go into goal. We'll find out who is going to take the first of the five penalties each. Don't forget, if it is still level after five each, we go to sudden death.
I'm assuming they practiced. There's so many penalty shootouts in these competitions. You must practice, you need to practice, but you can never, ever replicate what it's like on the day as you walk up those 50 yards and you feel the crowd, all eyes upon you, and the legs buckle just a little bit and the goal looks smaller.
All eyes on Halid Issa and his opposite number, Rustam Yatimov. It is Tajikistan to take the first penalty, and it's going to be the captain, Aktam Nazarov, who's taking the first responsibility here.
It's been played in a good spirit. Handshake between the two goalkeepers, goalkeepers' union, even in the Asian Cup. It's all part of the game. And then there's the added jeopardy for the goalkeepers. They must have a foot or some part of the body on the line when the ball is struck.
Instructions have been given. Halid Issa will be first to step onto that line. Probably a slight advantage for Tajikistan playing at this end, because at the other end, that's where the UAE fans are massed. Nazarov then, who chose to take first, who is taking first, up against Issa, top penalty, into the top corner. That is the way to start the shootout. And they will cheer every goal here, and the Tajikistan players will celebrate every penalty.
Yep, the neutrals are cheering every goal. It's a lovely penalty. Top corner, even if Kali goes the right way, he's not saving that. It's a brave penalty. It shaves the underside of the crossbar.
Abdullah Al-Hamadi is to take the next penalty. One who came through Al Jazeera's youth team. Fairly inexperienced at international level. Up against Yatimov. Oh, coolly done. Little shimmy sends the goalkeeper the wrong way. And calmness under pressure from the 24-year-old fullback.
I was wondering if Yatimov was brave enough to stand still, because if he stands still, he can kick away. As Al-Hamadi approached that, just had the look of somebody who's going to go down the middle.
Well, the man who scored the goal that put Tajikistan in front is next up in the shootout, Vedat Hananov from Persepolis in Iran. This to keep his side in front, up against Halid, who went the right way, but there's too much on it into the corner. Very good penalty from Vedat Hananov. No sign of nerves from him.
What a wonderful penalty. Hit the side netting. He actually hits the corner right to the back. That is textbook stuff. And it sums up a fine game for him.
Caio Canedo, the man born in Sao Paulo in Brazil, is next up. ...2-1... Tajikistan lead here. Three very good penalties so far. Yatimov in the way. Here comes Canedo! Saved by Rustam Yatimov! And Caio Canedo is the first villain of the piece as far as the UAE are concerned.
And it's a good save. He keeps the foot on the line. Didn't guess the right way, he chose the right way. First blood, Tajikistan. Now the important thing, a really important thing, is to score the next penalty.
Essen Panshambe scores for Tajikistan, who lead by 3-1. Up will step Fabio Lima. You can't beat the drama of a penalty shootout for a neutral, but for the spectators of these teams, it is nerve-wracking, it is nail-biting, but it is always emotional. Just making that the ball is on the spot. Paolo Bento knows that this is all down to individuals. Fabio Lima against Rustam Yatimov. sends the goalkeeper the wrong way. So two penalties each left, 3-2 Tajikistan lead.
One day, one goalkeeper brave enough to stand up. He commits one way straight down the middle, and that's a comfortable save for him. Is he brave enough? But it's an important penalty for Fabio Lima. Piles the pressure back on Tajikistan. Still only one miss.
Rustam Suarov. Just a couple of international goals to his name. This won't count as an international goal, of course, but it will count towards possibly a piece of history for Tajikistan. Here he comes up against Halid. Keeper goes the wrong way. And they're edging closer to the round for the quarterfinals. UAE have to score this next penalty, otherwise they're going out of the competition.
Again, straight down the middle. It's so nervy, so many players are doing that, they are gambling on the goalkeepers, gambling.
No Panenkas yet, I'm pleased to say. Don't think anybody's had the nerve to do a Panenka in a shootout in this competition just yet. It is Ali Salah, the man whose cross led to the goal that took us into extra time. Has to score, otherwise Tajikistan, on their debuts in the AFC Asian Cup, are going through. Ali Salah against Yatimov scores.
Clever penalty, he's been fabulous since he came on. Wondering why he wasn't selected in the first place. That's a lovely penalty. Little stutter, which you allowed because the movement continued. And Yatimov goes the wrong way. So it's all on this penalty. But remember, Tajikistan were just a minute away from victory once before.
It is the man who's had such a good, solid game in that midfield role for all three group games. And today, Alisha Shukarov plays in Tajikistan with Kuktosh. This to put Tajikistan into the quarterfinals. Bottom corner! And the debutants have done it! They've knocked out the UAE in the most dramatic of fashions here at the Amin Bin Ali. They've held their nerve. Five magnificent penalties at Petr Sagan's side are staying in this competition. The fairy tale is still alive. Tajikistan have won in most dramatic fashion here and are through to the next round.
What a sensational penalty, a 21-year-old taking on the responsibility of winning a place in the quarterfinal of the Asian Cup. What maturity, what technique. 1-1 at full time, the save from Yatimov from Caio Canedo. Typical that Peter Seghart is there to commiserate with UAE. But now we can go and celebrate. And he said before the game he might need a full pair of glasses if Tajikistan win, because the team break them with the celebrations. But what a moment for Tajikistan football.
Incredible. 106th in the FIFA rankings. They've beaten the UAE. It finished 1-1 after 120 minutes. 5-3. A penalty shootout win for Tajikistan, who will await their opponents. They'll keep a keen eye on tomorrow's game, of course, because they will play the winners of Iraq or Jordan. They'll be back here on the 2nd of February. And is it inconceivable that they could go another step further in this competition and get through to the semi-finals? It's been a dramatic night at the Amin Bin Ali. Australia booked their place earlier on today as well. And we've still got six more round of 16 matches to come over the next 3 days that I'm sure will bring equal amount of drama as we've seen tonight. Tajikistan will celebrate long and hard, as well they might. They are through to the quarterfinals. 1-1 it finished. They've won it 5-3 after a penalty shootout.